revenue of the council. And I got a reply to that just the other day. So I've asked the chairperson to set a time frame, because what has happened is we have the shops on the first floor at A and C block near the fish market, and the ones on top of Aram Soda opposite the taxi stand. And there are some shops which have become vacant on the first floor of 108 stalls in the municipal market, which are 54 which were built by the G Soda. Some people have surrendered. There's a total 20 stalls available as per the reply given. So I've asked them to immediately float the tender notice for auction of these 20 shops. Some minor repairs are involved. So simultaneously, it takes about a month and a half for that process. We will have to identify the number and break it down into one third. Suppose there are garment sellers, 30 of them. We have to make batches of 10, 10, 10. And then rotate the vending days among them. Also, for the Friday market, since we need to propose an open area, I moved a resolution taking this and both the issues in mind. The resolution says this council resolves to recommence pay parking for two-wheelers and vending activity in Mapsa Municipal Market by following norms of social distancing and wearing of masks by vendors, etc. This council also resolves to hold or conduct the weekly market on every Friday in the open areas by following norms of social distancing, wearing of masks, etc. at the following locations. I propose two locations which could be used to shift the Friday market. Now what has happened is today, being a Friday and last Friday, market has not taken place. There is no Friday market happening. I think two precious Fridays have been lost. So this is like we are going into the monsoon. And the vendors need this last couple of Fridays to make a good sale. And it's like a poor man activity. So for the time being, I'm proposing the Tempo stand near Nandadi building, and of course subject to availability, the parking lot of St. Jerome's or Milagris Church, subject to NOC from the church managing committee. Unofficially, some talks have taken place between the chairperson.
Ordinary meeting, a request also from MMA to waive off the shop print. We, the council, has decided to forward the same proposal to the state government.
So, then?
Yeah. Forward the same proposal to the state government and request the state government DMA to give a decision on it at the earliest.
What is the request?
There are three requests to us. No, they have made a request of 6 months leave, this thing. 6 months waiver. They had requested. Again, secondly, they requested was for deferred payment. That 19-20 up to 20 of March, they should be allowed to be paid up to March or 21st. That was second. And third applies the same for renewal. So the council has resolved to forward this same proposal to the state government and request the state government, including the director of DMA, is to give an outcome on this at the earliest. Item number two, as far as the SOCO contract is concerned, in view of 2 months of lockdown, and since we have not renewed the new agreement, the council has resolved to start taxis of SOPO agreement should be signed immediately with effect from first. Petition had come from Councillor Rasing Rane is regarding Ganesh Visarjan to provide alternative location in Mapsa. It's providing alternative location in Mapsa for Ganpati Visarjan. So people are aware of it. Tar river of the issue in law. Tar River, that bridge which has to be constructed, which initially I mean construct Kurbaja, which was initially supposed to be taken up 3-4 mele pehli. Covid ka lagun hun tari the delay zalya. So that is why that river also the movement that is been blocked. So till then, I think choti khatir ami hun tari ami alternative jago will be provided with water. where, how and all is yet to be decided. This is taking our technical team in consulting. Sandeep Falari had raised issues pertaining to revenue, and keeping in mind that the council has been struggling as far as the revenue is concerned for like 2 months of loss. And 2 months of fudey, I cannot imagine. This 2 months of loss is a loss. And 2 fully months, I cannot imagine. So he had also some inputs basically. I think I leave it up to him, let him.
This way, I'm arriving at a figure. Each vendor will get a uniform place of vending of 1.5 by 2 meters. This way we can maintain the social distancing. Between the two vendors also we get about 1.5 meters. So basically the major bulk of the vending activity takes place in these three lanes, opposite JKY and opposite Sargavagar Pharmacy and Paradise Pharmacy. So I've tried to focus on these three lanes and see that maximum vending is put there. What I'm proposing is over here and here, a row of vendors like this. I get a total of 46 and 46, 92 vendors here. Paradise, two rows of vendors in this fashion, 1.5 by 2 meters each space with 1 meter social distancing in between. The total number of vendors which can be accommodated is about 312. The local vendors which are presently put in front of the first row of shops, we maintain in the same location because that gives a very good positive sort of message that as you enter the market, you see the traditional Goan vendors, which is what market is all about. Like, now the only thing we have to sacrifice that four-wheeler parking, because the place for that four-wheeler parking is as it is being occupied by the local vendors, which are right now the Purumant stuff. Two-wheeler parking is proposed in front of the main row of shops, behind the main row of shops and opposite to that. So three rows will be only for two-wheelers. I proposed an entry like this and an exit from here. The two gates which are there, beyond that no vehicles will be allowed. I am also proposing that Shakuntala Square, the Shakuntala statue, will be entirely free of vendors as well as free of parking. That will be like a public square, which can be nicely done up with some pavers or some surface. And this way I feel the various types of vendors also I try to put wherever they are operating at present. And I also recommended that the town vending committee meeting be called as soon as possible, of which chief officer is the chairperson. I am a member of the town vending committee and all other members are there, the chairman of the MMA. And regarding item number 3 and item number 5 was taken jointly together, revision of SOPO collection rates and term and condition of SOPO contract in view of COVID-19. That was item 3. Item 5 was identification of open spaces for vending activities. Now what has happened is, I'll try to be as brief as possible. Last 2 months we have lost totally due to the lockdown. In the market, just from this May, 4th of May, the shops have been allowed to function. But the vending activity in the market has still not commenced. Secondly, the director, DMA, has written to all the councils saying that the weekly markets, he has given a table of the particular days, Mapsa Friday, some other councils have Monday, Tuesday, whatever. So they have said that henceforth, from the day of the circular, he said that the weekly markets will not be allowed in the traditional place on the streets or in the open areas as were held earlier. But he has said to identify an open ground where the weekly market can take place. Now that is one issue which I tried to touch upon. The other issue is the present market where the vending activity takes place. What happens is this has ramifications because right now 2 months have been lost. The SOPO contractor is going to give us letter after letter asking for rebate. So people are affected, vendors are affected, merchants are affected. People who are working, they are affected in a big way. A lot of people have lost livelihood, people have no business. But I feel, if not more than these people, as much loser is the council itself, because council is losing a major part of its revenue. So I suggested that we cannot allow this thing to happen since the relaxation has come in the lockdown. Now, lockdown will not obviously end by 31st May, there will be further extension. So I suggested that we proactively get involved and make things happen. I suggested two things. One is, by maintaining social distancing, let us have restricted vending activity as well as the pay parking for two-wheelers. We recommence in the market.
It has not been renewed. It has not been, agreement has not been signed. So the execution agreement will happen with effect of 1st of June. So basically, technically, from 1st of June, the commencement of
agreements are going to be.
As far as the hydraulics lift vehicle for cattle lifting, the council has resolved to hand over the vehicle to Govmanta Goshala with condition of providing the vehicles and assisting the Mapsa Municipal Council of lifting cattle as and when required. As far as the draft model Goa Municipal Solid Waste bylaws are concerned, the council is basically they have this matter has been deferred. Just keep in mind, I think we need more time to look into it. There are some more detailed study that we have to do and look into how to take it up. Probably the next 10 days or next 15 days, once we are ready, we can call for a special meeting and hold this.